Now, I don't want you to think that I did not like what I was doing. I'd been in mental health for almost 40 years, and I loved it. It's just that I'd been working since I was 12, and I longed to know what life would be like without a job. So I took the countdown to retirement clock given me by my daughter. I placed it strategically on my desk so that everyone passing by would see it. And I watched the seconds tick away for 3 years. Now, experts say you should plan your retirement, that if you don't, you're likely to be bored, and if you're bored, you're gonna get stressed, and if you're stressed, you're gonna get ill, and if you're ill, you're gonna die. Now, I'm a firm believer in justice, but the idea that I would work my entire life only to retire, get ill, and die, that wasn't just. I am a wonderful counselor. I can hear your words, mold them over in my mind, and give them back to you in a way that will promote your healing. But I didn't want to do that. I'd done it. I wanted something new, something I'd never done before. So I entered retirement without a plan. You see, I had no hobby. I had no artistic talent, and even less musical talent. In fact, when I was in the junior church choir, my grandmother was the director. And she said to me, "Please hum." So being the obedient child that I was, while all the other children were singing praises to the Lord, I was humming. And as she asked quietly, so I entered retirement and waited for the still small voice to order my steps. I waited an entire year, and then I heard it. "Rock the babies." Whoa. Where did that come from? I don't know. But it felt so right. So I began to research places where I could volunteer with babies. I found a small rehab hospital that admitted babies that had been in an acute ward in another hospital, but still weren't ready to go home. Babies born with congenital anomalies, babies born with birth defects, babies born drug addicted, and some had in fact been home but were returning because of abuse or neglect. I applied, I was interviewed, I took the training, I passed the background check, and I was ready to begin. That first day was so exciting. I met the nurses, learned the procedures, and was introduced to the babies. That's when I met her, Elena, who will be with me for the rest of my life. Elena was severely developmentally delayed. She couldn't hear, she couldn't see, and she had the weakest voice. Was about the best that she could muster. I thought to myself, how could I possibly soothe this child? I remembered what my play therapist friend had told me. Robert, when you get the babies, place them on your chest so they can feel your heartbeat and tell them that you love them. I pulled up a rocking chair next to Elena's bed. I asked the nurse to please hand her to me, which she did. I put my left arm under her bottom, placed my hand gently on her back, and pressed her against my chest and said, Elena, I love you. And then, from the bottom of my being, I began to hum. I lowered the octave so that I could feel the vibrations throughout my torso. And I imagined those vibrations going from me to Elena. In fact, from me into Elena. Shortly thereafter, I felt her body relax, and then she went to sleep. I was thrilled. From then on, when I rocked the babies, I would hum spontaneously. Not a particular song, just a melody that changed from one baby to the next, and with the same baby from one time to the next. And I imagined me and that baby, we're members of that junior church choir. And we're singing those praises to the Lord.